Sports coverage of the National Football League is on the air. Tonight, it's all on the line. We play for the Lombardi Trophy.
Todd getting the ball first.
Along with the man who has had to stick with me all season long, Charles Davis. And Charles, the anticipation, the hype, the media coverage, all in the rearview mirror now. We can finally get down to playing some football.
Yeah, don't worry about that part. I'll ride or die with you anytime. You know that. But here's the best thing about this. Everyone talks about trying to keep things normal as they approach for Super Bowl. There is no such thing as normal. The pageantry, the hype, all of that is more intense than anyone could ever imagine. What you're trying to do is embrace it in one way and make sure it doesn't totally knock you off your game. That's why the night before the big one, teams often switch hotels, try and give those guys that last chance to breathe a little bit before they go out and play.
They begin the drive with Hines, and he will lose yardage and be backed up to the 24. That's going to go as a loss of a yard, and it'll be second down.
That's a tough one right there. He ran right into the teeth of the blitz as the linebacker was freed up in order to stuff that one for a loss. I think quarterbacks got to see that. Got to find a way to audible into something a little more advantageous.
After the loss to start out, here's second and 11. To throw on second down is locked. He's going to flip one out here to his running back. And this one will go to the 28-yard line. It'll be a gain of four. And all of a sudden here, it's third down.
Well, it's tough to be a defender in today's NFL because there's so many things to account for in today's passing game, including the back sneaking out of the backfield. Not quite as bad as a turkey bowl where you have that center-eligible stuff, but still a lot of guys to account for.
A tough spot here on their opening drive. This is third and seven. They'll fake it. Now Locke. Out to his left. Now a hit and Locke. Lost the football. It's out. The Saints say they have it and they do.
With no running backs in the backfield to help pass protect, all the receivers in their patterns, it's going to be hot routes. If they sense a blitz or pressure on the quarterback, they've got to be prepared to break routes off early and get the football. In this case, never even had a chance. They popped the ball free in the backfield.
First opportunity upcoming in the red zone for the Saints. They've got a first and 10 at the 17. They'll run it for the first time with Alvin Kamara. And he'll be stopped after a gain of only a couple down to the 15-yard line.
He's definitely tough to get down. We just saw it right there. But how about what we did see? Pursuit, wrap up, and then the big finish with the tackle.
Drew, I love Drew.
Second down, Kamara. And he'll take it into the end zone for the Saints touchdown. With a first touchdown of Super Bowl 53. And the Saints have taken the early lead. And I'm sure for these guys, the break from the conference championship to the Super Bowl seems so long. To get out here and score that first touchdown has to take some tension out of the game.
Oh, I love the point you just made about the gap between. Think about the pressure that is built in the interim. To come out and get the first points in the Super Bowl, fantastic for the team.
Lutz now to kick this one away. And this will be a touchback as that sails over the end line. Here comes the Indianapolis offense now as they get set to take over. And last time, not only the turnover, but that turned into 6 points. They got to make up for that here.
We always hear about empty possessions. But some are worse than others. You can have an empty possession, punt the ball away, get yourself set to play defense. But when you turn it over, it changes momentum. And when they take it downfield and punch it in on you, that's a bad possession all the way.
And pressure coming, and they got him once again. Cameron Jordan able to get him for a loss of about three.
I know there'll be a little bit of criticism there because they went right back to the air after the huge pickup and ended up getting sacked.
That's often a play that you make. You feel like you've got momentum on your side.
Unfortunately, the O-line failed to hold up to try to keep that momentum going. Here's Hines. And he'll get about six up to the 27-yard line.
A quick burst there, and he nicely bit off a pretty decent game.
Throwing on third down, Locke. Call that a loss of seven to bring up fourth. Out is Rigoberto Sanchez on fourth down to punt this thing. The Saints offense now as they get ready to take over here. And coming up on their second drive of the game, had the touchdown last time out. Now they have the football back. Chance to really seize early momentum.
Feels to me like they had a really excellent week of practice. It all came together, but I'll bet you it got galvanized in the locker room and pregame. Somehow I think the head coach, his oratorical skills were on point.
Give him a couple on the carry there. Second and eight.
Well, they had that one sniffed out. Excellent run blitz. Stopped that one for a short gain.
What makes a good run blitz a good run blitz?
The ability to stay on task, to follow up your assignment, go to the gap you're supposed to cover, and not be deterred by anything else.
Clock rolling as we hit the midway point of this first quarter. Breeze leaves this one with Kamara. And he's going to take this one across midfield and into Colts territory. Tyquan Lewis makes a stop.
Brandon, all things considered, they have to feel pretty good about getting that type of a gain considering the blitz that they just had against them.
Some a new set of downs.
I think it all came together there. In breaking route, drove it with excellent pace. Money throw right there to move the sticks.
Now a first down carry. It's Kamara down right around the 25. 2 yards on the carry there. It'll be second down.
He's looking for some running room, and there wasn't a whole lot of it there on that play. I think he was lucky to get a couple of yards out of it because those defenders, they were rallying to the football pretty quickly.
Here we go.
Breeze to throw on second down. From left side, caught by Goodwin. And he'll be brought down at the 21, just shy of the 20 in the red zone. 4 yards on the completion, and it sets up a third down. Here's Kamara trying to run for it. And they'll get him down right about the 20. Only a yard of the pickup there, and it's going to leave him with a fourth down.
Well, this was just simply excellent defense. On this third down, they had to be alert for the possibility of a pass, but that didn't stop them at all from understanding what was going on when they decided to run the football, and they just swarmed and stopped them for almost no game.
So that's a seven-play drive that ultimately stalls out there at the end.
And things were a little leaky in the beginning on that drive, weren't they? But how about the front seven? As they got closer to their goal line, things stiffened a little bit, forced the field goal.
And now Indianapolis set to take the field. And it's been a rocky start for them thus far. They had the turnover and then the punt on those first two drives.
So there is optimism because they've improved, right? And turnover, you just noted it.
Punt's better. Punt's better than the turnover.
The punt is better on the second one. Now they're hoping to turn into first downs and hopefully points.
Luck and the Colts come up now first and 10 at their 25-yard line. Out of the gun, Luck. Eluding the play, and he can't find a receiver, and he's brought down. And that is the third sack this offensive line has allowed this first quarter.
Yeah, that puts him on pace. Let me do the rudimentary math here. To be sacked 12 times in a game, I know he's not going to go for that. I wonder if it's going to reshape what they decide to do on offense in terms of play calling.
Well, I can tell you what, when he popped up, shaking his head, frustrated right now behind center. Now, following the sack, they'll look to make amends on a second down and 17. From the gun, here's Love. Looking left side and he's got a man. That's Wilkins. And he's able to get up here to the 26. Give him 9 on the play. And that's going to lead to a third down. So barely time to catch our breath. Here's first and 10 just outside the red zone. Now a first down throw. Lock. He couldn't quite hold it. Got hit. Ball pops out. Incomplete. Seems like this defense, especially the secondary, has really been contesting about every throw in this first half.
Remind me of a good half-court defensive basketball team. Every time a pass is thrown, they're right there in good defensive position, able to affect the play.
Second and 10, Luck again. Finding a safety valve here. That's complete. Another good reception there. The Colts on the march.
So many times you hear today's NFL described as a space game. Get your best players into space with the football in their hands. That's why sometimes you just swing it out to your runner, get him out in the flat, and let him have a chance to make people miss an open field.
They'll try and run for it on first and goal. And this is going to result in losing yardage. They're driven back to the 8-yard line. It's a loss of a yard there, and now second down.
Well, it's been the air game that's taken them down on this drive before they finally turned around and handed it off on the last play.
And now they're looking for the big boys to get them in the end zone. Couldn't do it there.
It'd be interesting to see. Offensive lines had to pass block a lot on this drive. Will they be able to revert and fire out and create some space in the run game?
They get 3 yards closer, but still work to do. It's third and goal.
That run didn't get very far, and I think when you're looking at his dimensions, he's a little bit on the smaller side. He's counting on the big guys up front to escort him in, and they couldn't create any kind of space for him, could they?
Yeah, didn't get the push they needed. On third down, it's Hines, and he's into the end zone. Touchdown, Indianapolis. Naeem Hines taking it in from 4 yards out, and the Colts have got it back to a one-score game. Vinatieri out there to kick this one away. This will be taken to the back of the end zone. And no thought to bring this one out. He'll just go down to a knee, and they'll take over at the 25. Now the Saints offense, they get ready to go back to work here. And they're not going to play this conservative, I don't think. They had the field goal last time, and they're up, but they're looking to put a drive in the end zone.
Oh, I agree with you totally. No one goes out on the field and says, all right, let's just set up for 3, except in certain situations, trying to ice a game, that sort of deal. Most of the time, it's end zone, and that's what you're thinking, and I believe that's exactly what they're thinking as they begin this one.
Yeah, no quarterback ever goes out there saying, let's get free, right?
Not one that I've ever met.
Staying on the ground on first with Kamara. And he's across the 40, 3 extra yards to the 43. A solid run on first down, gain of 7, leaves him with a 2nd and 3.
Well, no matter how they phrase it, staying on schedule, staying ahead of the sticks, whatever you want to call it, 7 yards on first down. That fits the bill.
They'll run it now out of the gun. And he'll be brought down at the 48-yard line. 8 yards on the pick up there, and it moves the sticks.
Now, this is an example of breaking down a defense, because on a lot of these runs, he's getting past the point of attack, and guess what he's doing? Forcing the secondary guys to have to make a lot of tackles.
This is Ingram on first and 10. And they'll get him down here at about the 42. 7 yards on the pickup there, and it'll leave him with a second and 3.
Looks like they're establishing a pretty good pattern here, because they've been very heavy in the running game on the last 4 plays.
Yeah, you took the words right out of my mouth. So far, 4 plays in this drive, all 4 on the ground. A 10th carry for Kamara. And he'll get it down to the play to the 37. They get 5 out of that one, and it moves the chains.
So many teams want to throw the ball in this situation nowadays, but I love watching a team that has enough confidence to go ahead and run the football in that situation. That's almost a tendency breaker.
Breeze gives it up to Ingram. And he'll work his way inside the 30 now to the 28. 9 yards is the pickup there, and they'll have a second and 1.
That's a strong pickup right there on first down. And as this drive goes on, we're seeing an offensive line and running game imposing its will.
Now a handoff. Here's Kamara. And he'll be a little shy of the 25 here at the 26-yard line. 2 yards on the pickup there, but it's enough to give him a new set of downs. All runs on this drive so far. It's first and 10. Breeze now on first down. He's going to go up top for the end zone. So they took a shot on first down, but couldn't connect.
Boy, you will not see a quarterback of his caliber miss on one like that very often. I mean, there it is, wide open, got the shot, and he misfires.
We talk about, boy, he'll want that one back all the time. He definitely wants that one back.
Now a pitch out to Kamara. And able to break one tackle, but then quickly brought down. 1 yard, the official pickup there, so it's going to set up 3rd and 9. Play number 9 on the drive coming up, and they need 9 yards on 3rd down. 2 minutes to go here in the first half. We'll come back on Super Bowl Sunday after this. Play number 9 on the drive coming up, and they need 9 yards on 3rd down.
Got it.
Shotgun now for Breeze. He's going to take a shot for the end zone. And he's got it. Touchdown, Saints. Marquise Goodwin, 25 yards for the touchdown. And the Saints add on to their lead. A good hold in these wet conditions. The point after is up and good. And his guys will take a 10-point lead. Lutz now to kick this one away. That's fielded in the end zone. And he'll wind up getting an extra couple yards here for his trouble as he'll bring this one out to the 27. And now Indianapolis set to take the field.
And they had to wait a long time to get the football back. Probably not what you were hoping for when you got an offensive tummy.
Agreed. What you were looking for is a defense to get the ball back pretty quickly, right? Hoping for a 3 and out. So that didn't happen. You can't yell at your D for that. They've got to take care of their own business and reestablish themselves now that they're back on the field.
Now it's Lutz. High throw, but he makes the catch. 10 yards on the pickup there, and it'll be 2nd down. Now the Colts moving quickly here in the hurry-up offense.
I know many people like to throw to the tight end, maybe in a little flexed-out position because he creates mismatches with his size. The slot receivers do the same thing with their quickness, their speed, and their route running savvy.
Throwing again on 2nd down, but this time it's incomplete. And the hit jarred it loose. It's incomplete. The Colts on 3rd down. They've been okay, 2 for 3 thus far. They're looking at 3rd in the nose of the football.
They'll run it now out of the gun. And he's got the first before he's brought down at the 39-yard line. They only get two there, but on third and one, that's all they needed to keep the drive going. To throw is long. Steps away to his left. It's complete here to T.Y. Hilton. And he fumbled it. It's on the ground. The Saints say they have it, and they do.
We have seen this before, and we know coaches preach about this and work on it all the time. Catch the ball. You know there's going to be some traffic somewhere. They've got to put it away and secure it as they try and get downfield.
They start the drive on the ground. Kamara. And he's going to get this down to the 35-yard line. Great way to start the drive. 20 big ones and a first down.
Tremendous blocking by the interior of the offensive line. They didn't just gash him there. They blasted a gaping hole for him to gallop through. I think if he comes back to the huddle, he better be giving them a whole lot of credit. Thank
him. And he's got him. It's caught in the end zone. Touchdown, New Orleans. Cameron Meredith. 35 yards. And the Saints now at 6 to their lead. Lutz good on the extra point. And that'll make this a 3-score game now. The lead moves to 17. Lutz now to kick this one away. That'll be taken in the end zone. And now nothing but green ahead of him. Touchdown, Indianapolis. Naeem Hines, his second touchdown of the Super Bowl. And the Colts are able to draw a bit closer.
Well, he made the right choice by result, but a little bit surprising because now with touchbacks coming back to the 25 instead of the 20, when guys fielded that deep in the end zone, I think most coaches want them to take a knee.
Yeah, it's resulted in more kneel downs. Not right there. This will be taken to the back of the end zone. Out onto the field comes New Orleans. And we'll see how this is played. Offensively, they got the lead. Not a whole lot of time left. What do you think, Charles?
Well, it's tempting to try and add to your lead, but a mistake there, that can change things in a big way. I say go ahead, take the knee, get on out for the half.
And now here's a timeout called by the Colts on the defensive side of the ball. As they'll stop it with a little over 30 seconds to go in the first half of play. So the opening play of the drive goes backwards. Now they'll come up on second and 12. They'll run it now out of the gun. And they're able to get this one across the 35. And now we won't see a play on first down. We're going to get a timeout instead. As they'll stop the clock with 26 seconds to go until halftime. So after the run by Kamara, now another first and 10.
I'm waiting.
On first down, Breeze. And the tip there altered the ball flight, and it falls incomplete. It'll be second down.
And that's one he's got to be happy to have back. There wasn't a hole open in the zone.
You'd have to think on early downs like that first down there, need to be a little bit more careful.
Yeah, fortunately for him, got a couple more downs to play with.
They'll try again from the 36 on second and 10. Breeze again here on second and 10. That's Arnold. And now before this first down play, we're going to get a timeout here. As they stop it with 16 seconds to go in half number one. So from the 39 now, they'll come up on a first and 10. Throwing on first down is Breeze. Got a man, it's caught inside the 10. And all the way to the 2-yard line there before crossing over out of bounds. And give him a gain of 37. Two big plays in succession. Not sure this D knows what hit him, but now they got to get ready. It's first and goal. They'll run it with Kamara. And he takes it across and into the end zone. Touchdown, Saints. A great play there in the final seconds of the first half. And the Saints add on to their lead. And he's been a busy man, 5 for 5 now as he knocks another one through to extend the lead. Lutz now to kick this one away. That's fielded in the end zone. And the decision to bring it out, a good one, as he's up a yard or two shy of the 30. The Colts now, their offense works their way back onto the field. And from this spot in the field with the clock where it's at, you think we're just going to see a knee and that's it?
And I think in this situation, that's the proper play. But we do know there's some risk takers out there that may want to take one more shot before the clock runs out.
They run with Wilkins. Oh, he's got a little daylight. The Red Sea parts, and there he goes. And he's in for the touchdown on the final play of the first half. The prayer is answered.
How did they get that done?
And here on the road, that could be a huge score for their morale in the second half.
Every team has confidence going into the start of games, but sometimes you get it rocked a little bit, and they certainly applies here for them. But guess what? Just what you said, this touchdown can give them their belief back that they can win in the second half.
This is fielded a couple yards deep. And he'll take it up past the 25 to the 26-yard line. Out come the Saints now. They'll go on offense first here to begin the third quarter. They built a good first half lead. Now they have a chance to add on to it.
And what I'm thinking is that the offensive staff spent the entire halftime just working with them on, here's what we think they're going to do to attack us in the second half. Nice first half that we've had, guys, but be prepared for some change-ups. We're going to see them when we kick it off in the second half.
See how they handle any adjustments that might be made defensively. Running game working. They'll stick with it on first down. And he puts his head down and gets up to the 42 for a gain of about six.
Third quarter and you've got the lead. You're not ready to go into that four-minute offense to close the game out, but a running game can really benefit your team right now.
On second down, Ingram. And an alley to run. And he'll be taken down, but not before he works it past the 50. Give him 11 yards that time and a new set of downs.
They're trying to show that they can run the ball and protect this lead. Give it to the backs, play a little bit of keep away, don't you think?
And that's probably a good philosophy at this point, going to make that defense stand up and stop him. Toss play, Kamara. As he's got this down inside the 40 to the 39. 8 yards on the pickup, and now they'll have some options on second and short.
And there we saw one of the downsides of blitzing during a rundown, because sometimes you get out of your gaps. You don't fit the run quite as well because you're headed towards the ball carrier with abandon.
They'll run it now out of the gun. And he is going to be stopped cold behind the line of scrimmage. That'll be a loss of a yard, and it leads to a third down.
Hey, a lot of points have been scored in this game, but what a nice play by the defense. Stepping up on that one, maybe they'll get things going in their direction after a play like that.
The Saints on third down. They've been okay. 2 for 3 thus far. This time it's 3rd and 3. From the gun, it's Breeze. That's complete to Meredith. Touchdown, New Orleans. Cameron Meredith, his second touchdown of this Super Bowl. And the Saints now add 6 to their lead.
That drive that really increased their cushion felt very military to me. Very precise, methodical, as one of the words you've taught me. And they just got it done.
And slowly but surely now starting to pull away a little bit. Things looking good for them here in the third quarter.
Not only pulling away, but you mentioned that slowly but surely, you also drain clock too with a drive like that. So you really give yourself an advantage.
Now whistles, and we've got a man down. A man down here following the kickoff. While the trainers take a look, we'll step aside. Luck and the Colts come up now 1st and 10 at their own 24. Luck. And all this is taken in one-handed. What a catch. And they work this well upfield across the 45. That one goes for 24 yards. So one play, and they're already just shy of midfield. Luck on first down. Flushed out right. And seeing no options, he just tosses this one away incomplete. Now that'll bring up second down. Another incompletion with that one. He's just 7 of 14 throwing the football. 50%. Typically not going to get it done, is it?
And let's just make it simple. And that's exactly why they trail.
An incomplete pass on first down. That leads to a second and 10. A shotgun snap for Love. Dancing to his left. Now he'll let it go on the run. Deep. That's caught inside the 20. And they'll wind up getting this one all the way down inside the 20. And that one results in 35 yards. So the big play means just like that, they'll operate from the red zone now on first down. They'll run it now out of the gun. And able to push his way forward here for a good little gain. It's a 6-yard pickup, and it gets him to second and 4.
That play wasn't quite as big as the play that preceded it, but still, gotta like the way they're moving the football, partner.
Absolutely. Pretty good room to run on that last play.
Yeah, they didn't get a first down, but still, you'll take runs like that each and every time, won't you?
Buying time to his left. And he just chucked that one out of bounds, out of everyone's reach. Maybe a wise call not to take a sack in this part of the field. It brings up third down. Now they face a third down and 4 after that incompletion on second down. Now it's locked off the bootleg. Steps away. And he's got his man. It's Hilton for the Colts touchdown. T.Y. Hilton, an 11-yard touchdown. And the Colts are able to cut into this lead. Finitieri able to tack on the PAT. And that will shave one more off this lead. Vinatieri out there to kick this one away. This fielded a few yards into the end zone. Through an opening, and there he goes. Touchdown, New Orleans. Keith Marshall with officially a 103-yard return. And the Saints add on to their lead. It's been a back-and-forth game, a lot of points on the board, and that return right there kind of indicative of how this thing's gone.
Hey, you've seen both teams go at it, and as you just pointed out, both of them have found the end zone. But just like in boxing, you know the blow that hurts the most? The one you didn't see coming, and that often is the case when it comes in special teams.
And now Indianapolis set to take the field. I guess they have to feel a little gratified to at least get on the board last time, but still work to do.
No doubt about it. I wonder now if they're going to try to increase the urgency a little bit, maybe pump up the pace, maybe go 2 minutes. Who knows? Let's see what they decide to do.
On first down, it's locked. Escapes the sack. But now he's swallowed up and taken down. Cameron Jordan coming hard that time. He's able to run him down for a loss of 12. Here's Luck now on second down. Escaping the pressure right. Throw left side on target to Kane. Complete. And he'll be brought down right at the 30 here. That one good for 17 as they're set up better now for third down. They like going to him in the slot. He catches another one.
I think this comes under the heading of, until they stop him, why not go back to it? He has something going really well. Great working relationship with the guy throwing the ball, and they keep making the connection.
From the gun on third down, Locke. He may try and run for this. Only able to get back a yard for his efforts, and that leads us to fourth down.
How about a tip of the cap to the defense? They're working against a very mobile quarterback, but all day long they've kept him under wraps. And on that play, they held him to a short gain.
movement and a whistle, and they may have to rethink their plans on fourth down. A five-yard loss there is going to bring up fourth down. Now here's Rigoberto Sanchez as he'll kick it away for the second time. On the return that time, and the Saints will take over with a first down and 10. The Saints offense now, they get ready to head back onto the field. This is sort of what you would call a put-away drive, isn't it? They score here, especially a touchdown, it's almost out of reach.
It certainly feels that way, and I think that they're going to call their plays accordingly, because what you really want to do, even though you know the scoreboard is still up there and the game's going to go on, the fact you can take the spirit away from another team, that their drive and will to come back and win can be taken with another score right here.
Still third quarter, but you just get that feel.
Yeah, they're teetering right there on the brink, aren't they?
Again, it's Kamara. And hard running's going to get him over the 40 to the 42. Give him 6 yards on the carry. It's going to be third and three now.
I know the toss play begins with the guy taking the snap and turn around and tossing it to the runner. But where the real intrigue is, can they seal the edge? Whether it's an offensive tackle or a tight end in the direction they want to run the football. If they do that, that's the result that you get, that type of a game. If they don't, oftentimes it's not a very successful play.
Back now here on EA Sports. It's the Saints. They'll be looking to expand their lead here. They've got the football as we start the fourth. The Saints on third down. They've been good. 3 for 4 thus far. Here it's third and three. Working from the gun. It's Breeze. And he's going to be grabbed and pulled down. And no matter what the situation, the O-line just hates that because they feel like they didn't protect little brother back there, right?
Man, that's just so difficult for them, because just think about every single play. When you decide to throw the football, you're dealing with some of the best athletes on the planet. You talk about guys, if they weren't playing football, they'd be starring in the NBA at power forward. It's really a difficult task.
A good return there, 17 yards. And the Colts will go on offense here, first and 10. And the Colts getting ready to go. And down on the scoreboard, certainly needing to avoid what happened on the last drive, punting the football.
Sense of urgency has to take over for them here. They know the score. They know the situation. And by the way, the punter no longer exists for their offense. That's how they have to treat this drive.
They need points.
Big time.
The fourth down run successful. Now they look to pay it off on first down. On first and 10, Locke.
Throw the ball, man.
Alex Okafor, able to drop him for a loss of 4. On second down, here's Locke. He's going to air one out. And incomplete there. A nice hit. Jars the ball free and brings up third down.
This defense was definitely alert to the possibility of the deep ball, and they were more than ready for it.
They've got the lead, fourth quarter. Maybe can expect more passes like that downfield. An incomplete pass on that last play, and that means they'll need to come up with something here on third down. Here's Locke. Completing it here to Marvin Jones. His first catch of this Super Bowl, and it'll be good for a first down. You cannot write these guys off just yet, not with a quarterback like that under center.
You mean it actually crossed your mind with him running the team that you could actually maybe write this game off?
Not yet.
Not a chance. Not with him. We've seen it too many times.
Flush to his right. Now on the run. He'll throw it back deep over the middle. And it drops down incomplete. Thought he might have had it. Instead, second down.
this defense is continuing to contest every deep ball that is thrown downfield. And look, it doesn't matter whether you're playing man or zone. Eventually, that becomes man on man, and you've got to trust yourself and go up in that moment of truth and make a play on the football.
They'll run it now out of the gun. And no room that time, getting it to about the 46. Tackle is made by Cameron Jordan. Pretty good little two-play sequence there. You force the incompletion, then a very short pickup.
Yeah, now maybe you bring in an extra defensive back or two because you want to try and defend on third down. They like to play those nickel or sub packages, don't they?
Throwing on third down. Love, eluding the pressure right. And he took the contact as he was throwing it, and the ball drops incomplete.
Not only was the call spot on, how about the execution of that defense right there? Zone was absolutely locked up tight. He was trying to force it in there on third down.
But if there's a time to force it, he felt like he needed to make a play, right?
Yeah, exactly right. Third down, you got to try and find something. There's nothing available there for him.
It's caught. Jones. Now he's going to get this all the way down inside the 35. But no reason not to try it there, and they do indeed convert on fourth. On first down, Rock. That is caught at the 7. And he takes this one in for a Colts touchdown. Deion Kane, 34 yards. And the Colts are able to draw a bit closer. Two big plays in succession. Not sure this D knows what hit him, but now they got to get ready. It's first and goal. Now a toss play. It's Hines. And he takes it in for a Colts score. Naeem Hines with his third touchdown of this Super Bowl. And the Colts are able to cut into this lead. He's got the hat trick. 3 touchdowns now.
Did you throw yours? Did you throw yours?
I didn't have mine. You got yours. You've got one of those Abe Lincoln hats.
Yeah, and that stovepipe is going right out there for him. A nose for the end zone. Third time today. I think he deserves a tip of the cap.
Vinatieri out there to kick this one away. Out onto the field comes New Orleans. Now, the previous drive they punted, but that was just the first time they've had to do so in this game.
And when they turn on the game film, the coaches will rant about this, right? They'll say, oh, God, we got to move the ball, guys. We can't punt the ball away. But they have to keep smiles off their faces because that's the first time in the game they've had to do so. They've moved it quite well. They'll overall be happy with what they've seen.
They begin on the ground with Kamara. And able to stay on his feet past the 30 to about the 33-yard line. A good run there on first down, and it'll leave him with a second and 2. Here's a second and 2 now from the 33. Here's a carry now for Keith Marshall. And he'll be taken down right around the 34 after a pickup of only a yard.
Bottom line, they want to keep this clock rolling, so they'll take that one right there. They just want to keep falling forward, and they want to put the onus on the big fellas up front in order to bring this one home.
The Saints on third down. They've converted 3 out of 5 thus far. They need just a yard here. It's 3rd and 1. He can run for it, and he will. And he's going to have the first down yardage to the 35. Only a yard there on the keeper, but that's all he needed. First down. Ball up to the 35 now as they come up on 1st and 10. They'll run it now out of the gun. And this defense not giving him anything there. Maybe a yard up to the 36.
That's it. That's what you want. Straight ahead, positive gain. Just keep that clock ticking.
Time for a break. We're back to crown a champion after this. So 2nd and 9, and you'd have to figure just about all 11 probably crashing the line here. Now they'll run the option to the short side left. And he'll go out near midfield at the 49. And that one will go for 13 yards. turns on the keeper and a first down.
So finally, at this stage of the game, he lets his legs carry him for a big-time first down. But I think this is all set up by his eyes throughout the game. He's been taking it all in as he's watched this thing unfold. And finally, the eyes carried the legs and took him downfield.
You're right. His longest run of the game waited until the fourth quarter. And maybe that lulled the defense to sleep a little bit. Another 13 yards there twice in a row. And they're on the move. Another first down as well. Not totally home free yet, but it's looking good as they come up first and 10. Right back to him on first down. And he'll take this one down to the 36. Give him three on first down. It'll set up a second and 7. The recipe's pretty simple, I think, right? Just give your superstar the ball, continue to feed him.
Yeah, don't overthink this one, right? Make sure he's touching the football, but you're also counting on his intelligence in playing the game as well. If it's not there, don't force the run. Just make sure you hang on to the football and keep the clock ticking.
And now here's a timeout called by the Colts on the defensive side of the ball as they get it with 26 seconds to go in the football game. They're trying to keep the drive going. This will be play number 8. It's 3rd and 2. On 3rd and short, they'll try option left. Call it no gain on the keeper. It's going to bring up a 4th down. And another timeout taken by the Colts as they stop it with 22 ticks to go in the 4th. And well, they could just run this clock out, but here is the field goal unit on 4th down. He made his first, this from 47 yards out. And Lutz puts this one through. And that will get the lead up to 14. So they settle for just the 3, but clearly right now anything helps trying to salt this one away in the 4th.
Without a doubt, obviously a touchdown probably would have been the final nail to finish this thing off. But they still ate up time, got points. So while it's not mission accomplished, it's darn close.
And they're going to start this drive in pretty good shape as they get it up past the 30. The Colts offensive unit ready to see what they can do here. They have a little bit of time left here, but this one not going to go their way.
And this is where, in this situation for me, you just go ahead and run out the clock, shake hands, congratulations, and move on. Because now, you're not going to make up for what's happened during the game in this last sequence.
We'll see what they do here in this last sequence. And this is intercepted, and that should do it. Picked off at the 46, and they will set up shop at their own 46-yard line.
Obviously disappointing, but you had to go for broke here down 2 scores. So that forced you to make some throws you definitely wouldn't want to make. And I think this interception is going to pretty much write an end to this one.
They'll start out here with the option left. Finding room inside the 40, and finally down at the 36-yard line. And the Lombardi Trophy is headed back to the Bayou. The New Orleans Saints, Super Bowl champions. For the victors, getting to hoist that Lombardi Trophy. You know, we've talked to guys that have done it, and they say there's no better feeling in sports.
I don't know how there can be. The journey to get to this game is incredible. And then to finally break through and win it when all eyes are on this game alone because there's nothing else going on, that's just got to be absolutely amazing. That, the task, incredible. But the accomplishment, forever.
And they end this year just how everybody wants to end the year, holding the Lombardi Trophy. What a season for them. What a ride it's been for us as well here in the booth. For Charles Davis and our entire crew, I'm Brandon Gunn. Thanks for watching, everybody. We will see you next season right here on EA Sports.